boys and girls, welcome to yoga today. Now it's a horrible cold wet day outside today, so we're going to try and warm up the body. We're going to start standing at the back of our mat in our mountain pose. And remember, when we do mountain pose, we stand up nice and straight and tall. We tuck our bottom under, we pull our tummy in, shoulder blades, shoulders are down, and the crown of our head is up towards the sky. Take a big deep breath in, and we're going to bend forward. We're going to do a forward bend. So we're going to bend forward from the hips, keep our back nice and straight, and we're going to come down and see if you can put your fingers on the floor. You might feel a stretch at the back of your legs here. If that's too much for you, you can bend those knees. Now you might just be able to come down to here or hold onto your ankles. You might get your fingers on the floor. Your hands flat on the floor. You only go as far as your body will allow. Allow your neck to be long and your head to be heavy. And we're just going to hang here and enjoy the stretch of the back of our legs, but opening up our back as well. Now grab hold of opposite elbows and allow the arms, the head, neck to become heavy and allow it to sink to down towards the ground. Put your hands on the ground. You might need to bend your knees to do that, that's fine. We're going to walk the hands forward. If you need to bend your knees, that's fine. We're going to come into a downward dog position. So we're spreading our fingers out wide, separate the feet. Try and push our chest towards our thighs. Really try and push that chest backwards. We're looking between the knees. Now come with the balls of your feet. As you exhale, really try and push those heels down towards the mat. You're stretching out all the back of the legs. You're also loosening up your back here as well. So keep pushing the chest towards your thighs. Pushing those heels down towards the mat. Now we're going to come up on the balls of our feet and push those heels down. We're going to bend our knees slightly, look forward, and we're going to step through with our left foot. So we've got the foot in between the two hands. We're going to come down onto our knee and we're going to slide the right leg back. And you'll be able to feel the stretch on the front of your right hip. I'm just going to stop here in this position for a little while and feel that stretch. Take a deep breath in and raise the body up and place your hands on your thigh. Take one more deep breath in. I'm going to raise those arms up to the sky. You would add in a slight back bend as well. You're looking up towards the sky. Position. You're now going to place those hands back down on the floor, either side of your foot, and you're going to take the hips back. You can see that your front leg will straighten. This is called a half split pose. So we've got a straight front leg. Try and push that big toe into the mat, and you'll feel a stretch all the way up the back of that leg. Now I'm going to bend into that front knee again. So we're bringing our knee over our ankle. We're going to bring that foot back. So we're back in a tabletop position. So now I'm going to bring the other leg forward. So I'm going to bring the right leg forward. So the right leg comes between the two hands. And we slide the left knee back. So we have our knee over our ankle, in between our two hands, and the left knee is slid back. And you feel that stretch all the way down the front of that left hip. So we're just going to take a few moments here. We're warming up the body. And then we're going to push through that heel and bring the body up to an upright position. Place our hands on our thigh. big deep breath in. Raise those arms up to the sky. You might want to add in a bit of a back bend, a slight back bend, and look up to the sky. We're going to bring those hands down, either side of the foot, and we're going to take the hips back, and the front leg will straighten when we do that. Try and push that big toe into the mat, and you'll feel a stretch all the way up the back of that leg. We're just going to hold that for a moment. Now we're going to bend that front knee and come back into our lunge position. We're going to take that leg back. So we're now in a tabletop position. So our hips are over our knees and our shoulders are over our wrists. So we're going to do something called cat-cow. So we take a big deep breath in, and when we breathe out, we bring our hips under and our head under. And we're arching our back, curving our back, as if we were a cat. And then we're going to breathe in. We bring our bottom up to the sky and our head up to the sky. This is called cow pose. So we're breathing, exhaling, head down. Inhaling, head up. Inhaling, exhaling, head down. Inhaling, head up. And we're moving the spine here. Loosening of the spine. The whole of the spine. The shoulders. We're going to do one more round of that. So head down. Forward, so until you come onto your forearms and push the legs back. Now your shoulders, they are directly over your elbows, your fingers are spread out, and you're on your forearms, that's this part of your arm. And we're going to push through your hands, we're coming up to Sphinx pose. This is Sphinx pose here. So we're really pushing through those hands. Don't let yourself collapse into your shoulders. Really push through those shoulders and pull your shoulders down your back. This is Sphinx pose. You can go a little further if you want to by placing your hands a little bit further in front and then straightening your arms. And we're now in Cobra pose and looking straight ahead. If this hurts your back at all, come back onto your forearms. Pushing through the hands. This is a back bend pose that we're doing now. Come back to your forearms. Walk those arms back in. We'll push through those hands. Come up onto your knees and walk the knees in. Back into tabletop position. Now our toes are touching but our heels are apart. We want to lower our bottom down to our heels. Walk your hands back. Bottom comes all the way down to your heels. And then we're going to bring the chest down to the floor in between your thighs. So your thighs, you've slid your thighs apart. We're going to walk the hands forward. Then bring the chest to the floor. Your forehead will be left resting on the mat. And you can have your arms by the side of your body with your palms facing up. And you can have your arms straight ahead, above your head. You choose what's best for you. And this is our yoga resting pose. This is what we do to rest when we've had a hard yoga session and we've learned some new moves. This is the rest we do to give our body a chance to recover. Hands back under your shoulders, push the body up, bring the knees together and take your hips over to the side. We're going to bring the body over towards the feet. So we're sitting up nice and straight and pulling, really pull that body up away from the mat and lean over the body. Grab hold of the feet if you can, or the shins, the ankles, whichever is comfortable for you. And allow the head to become heavy. Allow your head to sink towards your knees. Raise the body up and come to a lying position. So we're lying down on our back. You might want to bring your knees in one at a time and just give them a little hug. You might even want to rock from side to side to give your back a little massage. And then slide your right leg along the mat and slide your left leg along the mat. We're coming into our Shavasana, our relaxation pose. Arms by the side of your body, palms facing up, and close your eyes. And just allow your body to relax into the mat. And feel your heels resting against the ground. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, rock your head from side to side gently. And hook your knees into your chest. And take your knees over to the right hand side. Bring them gently down to the floor. With your left hand, push the body up so you come back into a seated position. Easy pose with your legs crossed. We're going to circle our arms up towards the sky. Bring the palms together. Then bring your hands down in front of your chest. We're going to see our special yogic word, Namaste. Well done, boys and girls, I hope that's warmed you up.